Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on what is a lattice and what are the examples of lattice in discrete mathematics that can be discussed in this video. Okay, so let us first of all what is lattice. Let us consider L comma less than or equal to BA poset. So poset means partially ordered set. Okay, where L is a finite set, less than or equal to B a relation that can be defined on the finite set L. Now this poset is said to be a lattice. Okay, lattice. By taking any two elements from the given set as a pair, that is A comma B, that are two elements that can be taken from the finite set as a pair, belongs to L. Okay, so this pair contains both LUB, least upper bound, and greatest lower bound. Okay, least upper bound can be called as supremum, and greatest lower bound can be called as infimum. Okay, whenever this pair of elements from the finite set L contains least upper bound and greatest lower bound, hence we can say that this poset is said to be lattice. Okay, least upper bound can also be called as supremum. Greatest lower bound can also be called as infimum. Okay, least upper bound LUB of A comma B is equal to, can be denoted by, so A or B, or A exclusive or B. That means least upper bound of two elements from the given set L is denoted by A or B, or A exclusive or B. This can be called as join or sum of A and B. Join or sum of A and B. Whereas GLB of A comma B can be denoted by A intersection B or A into B. Okay, so this can be called as product or A meet of A and B. Okay, LUB of A and B can be represented by A or B, or A exclusive or B. This can be called as join or sum of A and B. Okay, GLB of A and B is denoted by A intersection B or A into B. This can be called as product or meet of A and B. Okay, so this is the description about what is lattice and what is LUB and what is GLB, how we are representing LUB, how we are representing GLB. So LUB is also called as join or sum of A and B. GLB of A comma B can be called as meet or product of A and B. Now we go for one example, check whether that poset is lattice or not. Okay, now go for this example. Okay, so this is the Hussey diagram. Okay, this Hussey diagram is a poset. Okay, now we have to check whether this Hussey diagram or poset is lattice or not. Okay, for that one, we have to take any pair of elements from the given Posset or a Hussey diagram. For that two elements, for that pair, we have least upper bound and greatest lower bound. Okay, if both are exist, then we can say that this Posset is said to be lattice. Okay, now we have to find out the LUB and the GLB for each and every pair of elements from the given Posset. For that one, so this is the LUB table and this is the GLB table. In the LUB table, LUB can be denoted by using union symbol. GLB can be denoted by using intersection symbol. Okay, whatever the elements in the Hussey diagram, so that are written either in row wise and column wise. Okay, row wise 1, 2, 3, 6 I am writing. Column wise 1, 2, 3, 6 I am writing. In both LUB table and GLB table. In the GLB table also, whatever the elements in the Posset, that can be written in row wise and column wise. Okay, so once we are writing all the elements in the Posset in row wise and column wise, we have to find out the LUB and GLB for each pair of elements. Now, so 1 R 1. Okay, so for the element 1, what is the least upper bound? So that is a 1. Okay, 1 and 2. For the element 1 and 2, what is the least upper bound? That is 2. Next, for element 1 and 3, what is the least upper bound? That is 3. For the element 1 and 6, what is the least upper bound? That is 6. Okay, next one, next row. For the element 2 and 1, what is the least upper bound? That is 2. For the element 2 and 2, what is the least upper bound? That is 2. Next, for the element 2 and 3, what is the least upper bound? That is 6. 2 and 3, least upper bound is 6. For the element 2 and 6, okay, for the pair 2 and 6, what is the least upper bound? That is 6. Next, third row. For the element 3 and 1, what is the least upper bound? That is 3. For the element 3 and 2, what is the least upper bound? That is 6. For the element 3 and 3, least upper bound is 3. Next, for the element 3 and 6, what is the least upper bound? That is 6. Next, go to the fourth row. For the element 6 and 1, what is the least upper bound? 6. For the element 6 and 2, what is the least upper bound? 6. For the elements 6 and 3, what is the least upper bound? That is 6. For the elements 6 and 6, what is the least upper bound? That is 6. We can take any pair of elements. For that pair of elements, LUB is exist. Then we can go for greatest lower bound. Okay, 1 and 1. So 1 and 1, greatest lower bound is 1. Okay, next one, 1 and 2. 1 and 2, greatest lower bound. Lower bound is 1. Next, for the elements 1 and 3, greatest lower bound is 1. Next, for the elements 1 and 6, greatest lower bound is 1. Next, go to the second row. For the elements 2 and 1, greatest lower bound is 1. For the elements 2 and 2, greatest lower bound is 2. For the elements 2 and 3, greatest lower bound is 1. For the elements 2 and 6, greatest lower bound is 2. Next, go to the third row. For the elements 3 and 1, greatest lower bound is 1. For the elements 3 and 2, greatest lower bound is 1. For the elements 3 and 3, greatest lower bound is 3. for the elements 3 and 6, greatest lower bound is 3. Next, for the elements, go to the fourth row. For the element 6 and 1, greatest lower bound is 1. Next, for the elements 6 and 2, greatest lower bound is 2. For the elements 6 and 3, greatest lower bound is 3. For the elements 6 and 6, greatest lower bound is 6. For every pair of elements in the given Hussey diagram, greatest lower bound is also exist. Okay, so here I am writing, for every pair of elements, in the given poset, so both LUB and GLB are exist. Both LUB and GLB exist. So hence we can say that, hence we can say that poset is a Lass. Because for every pair of elements, both LUB and GLB exist. Okay. So last statement we are writing, for every pair of elements in the given poset, both least upper bound and greatest lower bound exist. Okay. Hence we can say that given poset is a lattice. Okay. So this is the description about the what is a lattice. Okay. How we are representing the lattice. Okay. What is the example for lattice? Okay. Now we can go for this one. Okay. Whatever I am telling, so that can be discussed here. A lattice is a partially ordered set, that is poset L, less than or equal to, where L is a finite set, less than or equal to be a relation defined on the finite set, in which every pair of elements such as A comma B belongs to L, where A and B are the elements of the finite set L, has a greatest lower bound, that is a GLB, and a least upper bound LUB. We can take any pair of elements from the given set L that has a greatest lower bound and a least upper bound. Okay. So least upper bound can also be called as a supremum, and greatest lower bound can also be called as infimum. Okay. The least upper bound of a subset A comma B, subset equal to L, is denoted by ARB, A union B, or A exclusive RB, and is called as join or sum of A and B. So LUB of A and B can also be called as join or sum of A and B. Next one. The GLB of a subset, set of A comma B, subset equal to L, is denoted by A intersection B or A star B, and is called as meet or A product of A and B. Okay, these two statements can be denoted in the simple way. GLB of A comma B can be denoted by A intersection B or A star B. This can be called as meet or A product of A and B. LUB of A and B can be denoted by ARB or A exclusive RB. This can be called as join or A sum of A and B. Okay. Example, this is the given Hussey diagram. This Hussey diagram is a poset. Now, this poset is said to be lattice or not. For that one, we are taking any pair of elements from the given POSET or our HASSI diagram. Both the least upper bound and the greatest lower bound can be exist. Hence, we can say that this POSET is said to be lattice. For that one, we have to draw the LUB table and we have to draw the GLB table. Least upper bound table, greatest lower bound table. For that one, here we have to write LUB symbol. Here we have to write GLB symbol. Okay, this symbol GLB, this symbol LUB. Whatever the elements in the POSET or our HASSI diagram, that can be written in row wise and column wise. For every pair of elements, we have to write the least upper bound. For every pair of elements, we have to write the greatest lower bound. Okay. For every pair of elements, both LUB and GLB exist. Hence, we can say that this given POSET is a lattice. Okay. This is the example of lattice. So, thank you. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So, Divvela Srinivasarao. Thank you.